Hi, this is Jez from StarWarsHelmets.com.
Welcome to our latest online video review, and today we're going to be looking at our first replica helmet, and in particular, EFX's Clone Trooper from Attack of the Clones. A few years back, Master Replicas acquired the license from Lucasfilm to produce prop replicas for the Star Wars movies, and over the following years produced a long and extremely successful range of quality collectibles. Initially concentrating on lightsabers, they moved into replica helmets in 2005 with some really great products tied into the then-upcoming Revenge of the Sith movie. MR's license expired in 2007, but five members of their team decided to go alone and formed a new company, EFX, which subsequently picked up the new license from Lucasfilm. After finishing off on the Stormtrooper run started by MR, EFX has turned its attention to the Clone Trooper from 2002's Attack of the Clones. The first thing we should say in this review is it's difficult to actually compare this helmet to an original, since in reality none actually existed in the real world. That's because Lucas used CG for the clone costumes in both Attack of the Clones and Revenge of the Sith. Hence, we're restricted to comparing this helmet to what a computer visualized on screen, rather than an actual object we could touch. So that borne in mind, if we look at the helmet, we have to say that the results are very impressive. Since the same team responsible for Master Replicas helmets has produced this for the new EFX business, we have the same high level of quality we've come to expect. It is a very classy looking product, and as a display piece is the kind of thing that will impress friends. It's manufactured in fiberglass and has a solid and weighty feel to it. It's complemented by a fully velour lined interior, which gives it the feel of something like a motorcycle helmet. Although please don't ever try to wear one as a safety helmet. I'm presuming EFX had access to Lucasfilm's digital CD files for the development of this helmet, so it should be truthful to the appearance of the helmets in the original movie. Understandably, there are going to be some compromises when producing a real-world version of something that in essence has only resided in the memory of a computer. But from what we can tell, EFX has stayed very faithful to the original design. Perhaps the most notable exception being the lack of a lower neck ring, but given the way that most people will display this helmet, I don't think it's something that would be particularly missed. Due to the required thickness of the fiberglass the helmet's manufactured from, the visor sits a little way back, but again we really are nitpicking here. As a collectible, it complements the Episode 3 Clone Trooper and the Episode 4 Stormtrooper really well in an evolution of the helmets kind of way. Whether you agree with Lucasfilm's development of the character or not, the way that Master Replicas and EFX has visualized this is extremely impressive. Turning our attention to the rear of the helmet, you can see a really nice touch in that EFX has decided to add an LED to the rear of the fin. It's powered by a couple of AAA batteries housed in the inside roof of the helmet, a really nice addition. Though it's not the first time a licensed Episode 2 Clone Trooper has been produced, this is by far and away the very best, easily eclipsing the efforts Ruby's made in the past, including their more expensive deluxe version produced in 2004. It's due to go on sale from October the 25th and has a run of 1,000, which should be enough to cater for demand. It comes supplied with a pleasant looking and ergonomic display stand, along with a brushed metal plaque and a small brochure, and is likely to retail at around the $430 price range. So in summary, in our view, it's a slick and extremely well-made collectible that looks as good from 3 inches as it does from 3 yards, and will be a welcome addition to any collection. For more information and photos, go to StarWarsHelmets.com, the archive of helmets and costumes from the Star Wars galaxy.